did that hurt. So much so that it made me feel quite ill for 48 hours really. Although it looks swollen still, it's not hurting like it was. So today is Sunday, and the weather's not so clever, but we're moving on. Throbbing thumb or not. So, bye bye Barlaston. See what the day brings. Well, we're just going past the Wedgwood factory, which is famous for pottery and china production, and would have been a massive part of the canal business back in the day. Unfortunately, I don't think we manufacture much there anymore. I think it's all gone to China. China. Get the joke? Welcome to Stoke-on-Trent.
Which side are the bollards?
Here. Oh, the gate's heavy.
Yeah. Them.
I don't know what nationality he is, but he's taking pictures of us as we're going under that bridge. I already learnt Punjabi in Leicester, so I can't take on another language. This is Longton Road Bridge, which is low. It might even knock the aerial off the roof. So this section of the Trent and Mersey is urban Stoke-on-Trent. It's wooded, both sides of the canal, but it's got housing either side. You wouldn't really know it some of the time. It's pleasant, and you can always tell when you're near a conurbation, because the towpath is busier with pedestrians and cyclists. And you know what they say about the sun shines on the righteous? Well, the sun's poked out now, it's really very nice. I don't know if that lady on the bike's a vlogger, but she's going along with a helmet on, and on top of the helmet she's got a camera facing backwards and frontwards. These houses along here have had sun decks put on the rear. I'm sure they're an after build after the original was built, but they're taking advantage of the aspect they've got. So we've just gone through the area known as Herne Heath. Coming up to the bridge, which I suspect is the course of the old Michelin tyre factory railway. Well, this is another low bridge. which 108, is that aerial going under it or are we going to knock it? Right, duck, mind your head. So there's another low bridge, bridge 108A, and that's going to hit it. Bang, there it goes. Duck. In front of us is an incinerator. I'm not quite sure what they incinerate. Which 109. There's a very unpleasant smell in the air. I'm suspecting it's coming from that incinerator. Tackle and bait, air guns, archery, boats and engines, country and western line dancing. What was that?
Where do they
about?
Do that? In the canal?
This section here reminds me of something you might see in Thailand on their canals. They've got a viewing platform on top of that shed. Fancy tiling gone on there. Sounds of the town now. We're just going past Jones and Shufflebottom. Bathroom heating and builder's supplies. First of the locks that are in the Etruria area of Stoke-on-Trent. Stoke locks. And there's a boat coming in to go down. Well, the first one of the Stoke locks is a deep one. I second lock of this under a railway bridge into it, and looks like original cobbled towpath up a steep flight of steps to it as well. This is tricky because I've got a kneel down basically, so I don't bang my head on this bridge and get it into the lock without any serious mishaps. Two old kilns there from the pottery days. Can't get the top of it. The geese have been helping me with the mooring rope. So there's another low bridge. I've actually got to bend down to walk through. This is the third lock going up on the Stoke flight. Twyford lock. And there's a boat coming down. Makes it a little bit easier. So by bridge 116, just prior to the lock. Is the Etruria Industrial Museum. Used to be a bone and flint mill. That's a view of the museum from the lock. It's got a really tall steeple. Fred Dibnah, where are you? Well, this is interesting. The water level in the next pound between top lock and this next lock down has dropped so much the boat's not floating at the moment. So we've had to go up and let water out of the top lock to refloat the pound. It's floating now.
All we've got to do is form the paddle
yeah,
now.
Well, that was interesting. This pound, the water level, you can physically see it going down, and the boat's just sitting on the bottom. All part of a day out on the canal, I guess. Sling it down if you like. You can sling the rope down if you like. It's only when I'm not on the boat. Yes.
How can you hear me?
I'm nosy. Okay. It's the SIM cards with ID Mobile.
ID Mobile.
Who are part of the Courage Group.
Oh, yeah.
And it's on the 3 network.
On the 3 network?
Yeah. I normally got signals, not often I struggle.
Yeah.
It's £16 a month unlimited.
That's not bad, is it?
And I took the phone out at home and I use that at home as well.
Do you know what? What you do is exactly what I've said, because we're out for 6 months of the year.
Like, yeah.
So for 6 months of the year, BT internet, and I sat at home doing nothing.
Yeah.
So I thought I'd get a little dongle, a little 3 dongle.
Right.
But you've got a router then?
Right, well I pay quite a lot of money for the router, but I thought it was money well spent.
Yeah.
It's a Nighthawk Mark 1.
Yeah.
Cost me £200. It can be as much as £350,
yeah,
but I managed to get it on eBay for £200.
Yeah.
And I take it with me everywhere I go.
So if you go home, you use
it
for your Wi-Fi.
I take it home with me, and if we go abroad in the winter, which we do, I take it there as well.
Yeah.
And it works, a treat. And it's not often we struggle, is it?
Because we always tell us our phones.
Yeah.
We both got 40 gig on our phones.
Yeah.
And 80 gig in a, if we stream some telly or something, if we get close, but we never run out.
No.
But I feel annoyed at paying BT at home, £20 a month worth of this. And of course you're not allowed to leave. If you leave BT, to keep the email address, they charge you £8 a month.
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
So you've done what we planned to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the router, I can't fault it. It's a Nighthawk. and the aerial is a pointing omnidirectional aerial.
And that's just in the square box with a magnetic
it is.
Mast.
And it stands up when the bridge doesn't hit it.
That's what I said.
So how am I going to remember what they are?
I can remember.
I'm going to send a message to the WhatsApp.
Changing the subject, do you know where the water point is here?
Yeah, just
around
the corner. Are you going?
Sorry, Katie. Technical talk.
I thought yes. You said we're not talking phone today. She said that makes a change. I said yes.
So, got lucky. I've moored up literally outside the Toby Inn. I think that calls for a nice roast dinner. Surrounding area, Black Prince Holidays over there. One of their boats drove straight into me yesterday, straight along the side.